And the stand-up comedy is, somebody spoke about breakups and then a family walks up here. So, yeah. My name is Jagannath. I'm supposed to be Jagannathan, but my parents decided to name me more Indian. So they named me Jagannath because we were in Delhi for a long time and people wouldn't want to mistake me as LTT. So, yeah. I must begin with. I chose this, so I don't do stand-up comedies, so it's not going to be really funny, I suppose. So I chose this because I'm paying for this. It's not, right, so, like, I'm not gonna give a damn if you laugh, I'll just have my cold coffee and I'll leave and watch my World Cup, right? So, we are strangers and things just die down here, it's just like a bad relationship. It's just over. World Cup, so you must be following World Cup, you must want to go and watch the finals. I am a fan of football, but not this World Cup. A lot of the great men that we know about football are just gone. Belgium, for God's sake, I thought there's a chocolate company which is winning the third position. And don't even get me started about Croatia. The only time I know about Croatia is when I, you know, stumble upon it accidentally on Google Maps and I wanted to go to Chrome Pit. But yeah, and France, of course, everybody knows France. I know France because I took French as my second language. And then people thought that when I'll take French, I'll get a lot of marks. And then I'll change the future. I'll be like Abdul Kalam. And here I am. So education. I don't quite understand this. So we are a population that has got more number of people than the sperm count of a hippopotamus. And we can't actually assemble 11 fuckers for a football match. There are kids in the house. I'm really sorry. Might be the wrong event. But of course, this is good to be better than a Salman Khan movie. So, there are worse things that your kids are seeing outside. You have people pissing on the road, people honking all the time. I suppose this is going to be a little bit better than that. Yeah, so the reason why we are actually a bit wary is we feel edgy about talking about few things, right? I'm really commendable that people spoke about rape. People spoke about a lot of other things. I think I really wish we do that every time, more often than just these places, right? Things like feminism, for instance, people become very edgy, especially as men, is it not? Feminism is like, we agree to everything that what feminism has to say, like at least 90% of it. We just don't like us men don't like it to be said from a woman. Like a woman should not talk about feminism because it gets into our egos, right? that's where we actually, and perhaps we should do that more often. We should let people speak. It's just not something that has to be told in media or by some man who we think is great, right? Yeah, so we talk about a lot of stuff. So we are in a place which is regarded as posh. There are a lot of places in Chennai which is regarded for their economic status, right? And somehow or the other, the names that these places have also sounds a bit synonymous or that characterizes that place or their economic status of that place. Like for instance, if you talk about Mylapore, the moment you talk about Mylapore, you hear things like Carnatic music and filter coffees and notice boards which says only vegetarians are allowed here. But then when you talk about Vyasarpadi, for instance, you're not talking about stuff like that. You're talking about shambles and poverty, right? Because it sounds like a place where you have shambles and poverty. You talk about Purusavakam. Purusavakam, it's like very, very hectic place where you don't have a place to walk. There's characters to places. And same way, sometimes these places or these names might actually be deceiving as well. Not every name, not every word might sound or might mean the same way. Like when I was a child, I thought the word masturbate means like you are a master of something. Like you excel. It's like, I thought masturbate is like the final stage of a video game. Like you have beginner, you have medium, you have an intermediate, you have an expert, and then you have masturbate. I swear, it's true. Like if a guy is gonna come and tell me that I did bachelor's of engineering in computer science and I did masturbation in blockchain technology. I was like, whoa, I would like to do that as well. Talking about education and all that stuff, I mean, we also hear a lot about Azadi and stuff. Why don't we just, for the sake of it, can we shed our surnames first and then we talk about everything that we talk about? I think that kind of solves some problems, I think. I hope it does. I talk about all these things and then people tell me, you're a effing Naxalite, dude. You are a communist. I'm like, no, I'm an IT professional. like I work on Excel sheets, man. I'm not a revolutionary. It's just sense that I think I'm talking about. Like, if I turn up late for 5 minutes, the cab driver yells at me. That's what I am, right? You don't have to be like a revolutionary or be stuck to an ideology to talk what is really that makes sense to you. Just to end of it, I'll just say, so I stopped and decided to walk when I saw this man whose choices were lesser than my rejoices. Thank you very much.